Nakipagpulong si DOTR Secretary Jaime Bautista kay Chinese Ambassador Wang Silian para sa posibleng pagpapatuloy ng usapan sa naunsyaming malalaking railway projects na dapat sanay ipauutang sa Pilipinas ng China. Ito ang North-South Commuter Railway, ang Subic-Clark Railway at Mindanao Railway.
The Chinese wanted 3% interest on the loans, no? But the previous government thinks that it's quite high. They will see to it that the contractors that will work will provide or will give us very competitive rates so that the overall cost of constructing the projects will be cheaper. Even the interest rate may be a little bit higher. Because he said the interest rate is a very small portion of the total project.
Mas mataas ang interes ng utang sa China ng 3%, gayong 0.01% lang kung uutang ang Pilipinas sa Japan.
We're not limiting our options to China, no? We can also consider working with Japan and JICA. 6 years may not be enough, Karen, no? But I think if we start it and we do it right, we should be able to substantially complete the project before the term of President Bongbong ends.
Ayon kay Bautista, tumaas sa 160 billion pesos ang budget ng DOTR ngayong 2023 at malaki rito mapupunta sa sektor ng tren.
We are trying to finish this Tutuban to Malolos and up to Clark. I talked to the Japanese and Filipino contractors last week, and they told me that we should be able to have this line by end of 2026.
Prioridad rin ni Bautista na palawakin ang ating international airports.
I would like to have a facility which is comparable to the facilities in our neighboring countries. Me personally, I think we should transfer the international airport to another location. Expansion in terms of providing a very good customer experience is what we're looking at. The veto will not affect the construction of Bulacan Airport.
Tiyak din ni Bautista na matutuloy ang naunsyaming rehabilitasyon ng NAIA.
This airport, we have two runways that intersect each other, no?
Yeah.
Maybe it's very difficult to have a third runway on this. No? And I think the 35-year concession might be too long. One project that we are focusing on is the improvement of the Tacloban Airport, improving the Bohol-Panglao Airport, the completion of the second runway in Cebu.
Bukas naman si Bautista sa rekomendasyon ni Senator Robin Padilla na magtayo ng cable car sa EDSA para maibsan ang traffic.
When that statement was made by Senator Padilla, I asked our Undersecretary for Road Sector, no? To look at it. No? We will conduct a study, no? Because you know, for you to be able to implement a program, you need to get all the important data. Sure. No? The ridership will ride this. Will this be sustainable? Will this be profitable? Mm-hmm. Will private sector be interested to operate it?
Tiniyak din ni Bautista na dadagdagan pa nila ang mga bus sa EDSA busway bilang paghahanda sa face-to-face classes.